Good morning, everyone. Here I am at Pallakumpura railway station once again after 1 month from my previous visit. Today I am going to start trekking uphill towards Ambevela. In a way, I am going to continue my rail hike which I started from Nanuya last month. So we'll be trekking from Pallakumpura to Ambevela. That's approximately 9 to 10 kilometers in length. And we are at 1,707 meters in terms of elevation. That's roughly 5,600 feet. So let's start our trek and head towards Ambevela. Not sure what we will come across, but we'll discuss the journey in detail as we trek along. So stay tuned. This is Sri, and my trekking partner for today is Atula, one of my usual trekking partners. Last time I was here all alone, but today I have a bit of company. This is the Sripada seen from Pallakumpura railway station. To the right is Del Mountain. There's a small gap, that is the Fordyce Gap. I must thank Mr. Chaminda Jayathunga Aranchi for providing this information through my previous video on YouTube. This is along the length of the Pallakumpura railway platform. These days, all the trains stop here, including the night mail. Alright, here we are on the railway line, leaving Pallakumpura behind. We actually got very lucky. We met a very friendly shop owner who was very helpful and helped us with the directions and the surrounding geography. We started the trek at Pallakumpura station, 1,707 meters. Our target is Ambevela railway station today, that is at 1839 meters. So the elevation difference gonna be 132 meters or 433 feet. There are no tunnels in this stretch, but there is a very prominent bridge near Elgin Falls. Here is set of abandoned railway quarters. These are the things I've been telling in my previous journeys, we should convert to people like me. Yeah, we can hike along the railway track and spend the night. Here is the first stop, railway bridges we are going to encounter in this journey. So today I plan to introduce you to the railway line and the surrounding mountain ranges which the railway line goes through. So let's start from Watagoda, because that will help us better understand. So if I can walk you through the mountain ranges between Watagoda and Pattipola, I think that should give you a good overview of the surrounding geography. So now this is the Pallakumpura railway bridge, very small one. In my previous journeys, I think that was at least 8 years ago, in 2013, we visited Pallakumpura during one of the rail hikes, and there are two waterfalls in Pallakumpura, but unfortunately these days water levels are so low, I don't think we'll be able to see them. Alright, this is the second railway bridge. Today there seems to be a cleaning project going on either side of the railway line close to Pallakumpura, which is really good, because sometimes, especially during my last journey from Nanuya to Great Western, I came across massive bushes almost covering the railway line. I actually had a tough time figuring out which is railway line. So I think them doing this is highly commendable. Maintaining the railway line has been one of the biggest issues why train delays are occurred, because trains run really slow, around 10-15 kilometers. So invariably that will waste a lot of man hours. Okay, let's take a look back on the journey where we came from.
This is the line that we walked from Parakumpura. You see, there's a bit of a V cut. That's where people are clearing the railway line so that the trains can go without any hindrance. Here's a closer view. Okay, let's continue our journey. We are now close to the edge of Parakumpura village. We'll soon head into the forest reserve where the railway line goes through, and that one will be the most scenic part of this journey. And Parakumpura is located approximately 1700 meters above sea level. You can see there are lots of vegetable patches, which is their primary source of income. This is the view of Parakumpura village. The station is in the far distance to the right. On the left hand side of the frame, up in the sky, is the majestic Great Western Mountain Range. Alright, before I tell you about the 9th highest mountain, look at the 7th highest, which is the Great Western Lady, looking so sexy. You can see her over these villages of the Parakumpura. Okay, we are now officially into the forest patch. This is, remember last time I couldn't figure out which part was this, but this is the mountain range separating railway line and Parakumpura from Meepilimana Blackpool areas. So this is technically called as Meepilimana Mountain Range, which comprises of waterfall point, which I believe close to Elgin waterfalls, and also the 9th highest mountain in Sri Lanka, that is the Conical Hill. Conical Hill also part of this Meepilimana Mountain Range. Now I promise to tell you the railway line and the surrounding mountains. So let's start from Watagoda. Now the going is really good. So the train enters into Watagoda Great Rail Track Loop. Remember, at the tunnel number 16. It then goes along the base of Great Western Mountain between Watagoda and Great Western. Then Great Western Mountain gives way to Radel and to Singletree. So the railway line goes along the base of this from Great Western, Radel, then take a sharp right to Nanuya at the base of Singletree Hill. That is the, if I'm not mistaken, it is the 11th highest mountain in Sri Lanka. So the Nanuya, the river Nanuya, which flows from sluice gates of Gregory Lake, flows close to the Nanuya railway station. If you watch my previous journey, you would have noticed it. Then railway line continues through Nanuya Gap and enters Edinburgh Tea Estate. So Nanuya Gap to Edinburgh Tea Estate, it now enters the Meepilimana Mountain Range, keeping Parakumpura on the western slopes of the Meepilimana Mountain Range. So this is normally called as Waterfall Point Meepilimana Mountain Range. So this is where you will find the 9th highest mountain in Sri Lanka, which is Conical Hill. Now you can make out Sripada Mountain in the distance. To the right is Del Mountain. Through the Fordyce Gap we can see Sripada. To the left, down below, is the Diagam, and you can also note Diagam Tea Factory. Amazing sight. Unfortunately, it looks so hazy today. If it was a clear blue sky, this view would have been majestic. Alright, we were talking about the Meepilimana Mountain Range and the railway line when we got distracted by, once again, Sripada, the most sacred mountain in the world. Such a close place to my heart. Whenever you can see Sri Pada, no matter where it is, no matter whatever you are doing, it's always a very pleasant sight, and it helps me regain my composure, calmness. Wonderful sight. Anyway, now back to the railway hike. Now, when the railway line enters to the Parakumpura stretch, now the Meepilimana mountain range is to the left. That's where I told you the ninth highest mountain, which is Conical Hill, 2166 meters. If my mathematics is correct, it's 7106 feet. I guess it's right. So we have a very beautiful forest patch to our left, and to our right is sort of like a valley where there is a river. I'll tell you about the river later on, because we need to focus on the mountain range first. Okay, I'll have to keep my focus on these very distant sleepers. Maybe in a little while I'll tell you about it. Now, this is the beautiful railway line we have to go. I was telling you about the mountain range. We stopped at Conical Hill. Right, let's go ahead and continue our discussion. Okay, so the Meepilimana mountain range continues past Ambevela, Pattipola, all the way to tunnel number 18. So that's where the upcountry railway line leaves the Meepilimana mountain range and enters to Ohia. Then to its left is the Valimada Valley. To the right, Houghton Plains National Park, all the way towards Idalga Sind. So this is the story about mountain range. Now that we have done away with the mountain range story, I'm going to give you this panoramic view from the railway line itself. To the right, extreme right, you can probably make out Sri Pada once again. There you go. Today it's all about Del Mountain and Sri Pada. And I really love the tea estate down below. Just amazing sight. So I hope you now have a fairly good idea about the mountain range. When you are traveling on the train next time from Watagoda, from the tunnel number 16, keep an eye on for these landmarks. Now here the railway line is very straight, but you can see the line itself is in very poor condition. Railway sleepers are sort of like torn and very old, in need of replacement very badly. Alright, we are once again into a very beautiful stretch. Now I have lost count the number of times I use that word beautiful, or gorgeous, or amazing, or wonderful, all these adjectives, because I don't think even the Oxford Dictionary or the Cambridge one has enough adjectives to describe the beauty the Mother Nature has created in conjunction with the railway line. This is so wonderfully blended together. It's as if railway line has always been a part of the surrounding area here. Now I promised, well, I didn't make a promise. Remember, the first Sinhala movie was Kadavunu Porundu, or Broken Promise. Therefore, I don't intend to make a lot of promises. Nevertheless, I implied in a way, okay, that's more like it, I would tell you about the river flowing to the right along the valley. So that is the Dambagasthala Oya, also known as Elgin Oya. This is part of the Agra Oya, or Agra River. Agra Oya is the headwaters of the longest river in Sri Lanka, which is Mahavali. If you have watched Mr. Jackson Anthony's Ganga Dighe program, you would have known all these things. If you haven't watched it, I highly recommend you watch it, because it was a very well made documentary giving lots of history, very invaluable information. So highly recommend you watch it. Now back to Dambagasthala Oya, which is the one close to us. This Dambagasthala Oya originates from the Ambevila Reservoir, also known as Black Pool. This Black Pool collects its water from the Horton Plains National Park, like the water sources of probably Thottupola Kanda. So the water out of the Ambevila Reservoir flows as Algean Oya, also known as Dambagasthala Oya. She creates one of the most beautiful yet extremely difficult to reach Elgin cascades. There are a couple of them located close to each other. Why it is called Elgin is because of the Elgin tea estate in the vicinity. Alright, the site is getting more beautiful as we speak and trek along. This Dambagasthala Oya flows and merges with Agra Oya, and she also originates in Horton Plains between Thottupola Kanda and Agra Bhopat, that is on the Diagama Trail. Okay, I think I just blocked Atula's photograph because I couldn't stop. Anyway, now this Dambagasthala Oya flows and merges with Agra Oya. I need to make sure I don't confuse the two names. Agra Oya near Tispane Junction. Now this Tispane Junction is not the one you find in Kotmale. This is on Lindula Diagama Road. This Tispane Junction is very famous for a couple of tea estates like Kowalhane Estate, Henfold Estates, Waltrim Estates. There are so many tea estates. So there is a bridge called Kowalhane Bridge or Henfold Bridge, that is H-E-N-F-O-L-D. So the Agra Oya flows underneath the Henfold Bridge. As soon as she comes out of it, Dambagasthala Oya merges with her. These two become Kotmale Oya, flows to Lindula, then Talavakkale, creating Upper Kotmale Reservoir. To the same place joins Nanu Oya. I've been telling you about, originates from Gregory Lake with the water streams of Singletree, Radal and Great Western Mountain. Very interesting story. These are the railway S's. You can see this beautiful bendy railway line. This is what we came from Parakompura. Now let's take a look at towards Ambevila. This is a pretty straightforward area. You can see the 132nd mile post. Unfortunately, the trains can't go very fast here despite it being straight and somewhat flat, because the railway line is not in a very good condition. Alright, now you can see we are back on these tiny concrete sleepers with hardly any ballast between them. So I'm technically hopping like a rabbit from one to the other. I actually completed my story about Dambagasthala Oya. So we don't want to continue our story beyond Upper Kotmale Reservoir, because I think Jackson Anthony had done an excellent job. So I'll let you watch that program. Maybe if I ever get lucky to do that, follow his journey, I might be able to do this for you. Nevertheless, now that we are on the railway line, I told you the difference in terms of elevation between Parakompura and Ambevila is 132 meters. That is 433 feet. Ambevila is at 1839 meters. Beyond that is the highest railway line, Pattipula, 1891 meters. Now, I myself is surprised how I remember these numbers. It's very strange. Keeping it aside, so the Pattipola at 1891, summit level at 1898. Remember the story about the provincial borders between Pattipola and the Tunnel 18? If you don't know that, that means you have not watched my video from Pattipola to Tunnel 18.
This is that long straight bit of the railway line we just passed. And this place is quite special. When we walked on this line in 2013, this was in very good condition. Very sad to see the current state. An excellent lodging when you are hiking on the railway line. Rail hikes offers some beautiful shots like this also. As I always say, beauty can be found anywhere, even between two concrete railway sleepers. These ferns are quite unique and add beautiful addition, beautiful perspective to these upcountry mountain forests. Please protect them. Tiny flowers full of this area looks like a flower garden.
Right, you can probably make out Atule is walking ahead of me. The railway line crosses the provincial borders of Uwa and Central four times between Pattipola and Tunnel 18. Twice before the summit level, twice after the summit level. Remember, last time I mistook it, but I managed to correct it during the journey. And I also gave you a bit of information about the Udupusela railway line, which could have been the highest railway line, railway point, station, all that, if it was in existence. Unfortunately, we lost it in 1948. We gained independence, but we lost UPF, unfortunately. Alright, Atule is disappeared now. Hope he's not being dragged away by mountain leopards who are roaming freely these forests. Now, I did not mention that to alarm you, because remember, there are leopards roaming around these all the time, because this is their territory. This is why we need to safeguard these forests, not only for the water sources but also for this highly important and exotic animals we can come and enjoy from time to time. You can probably hear a water stream. I think that is one of the most soothing sounds in the entire world. Flowing water, rustle of the winds, birds chirping in the morning. Those are, I think, better than meditation at times. Anyway, I find it really difficult to walk from one step to the other holding the camera still, so I'm going to stop you right here. We just passed another set of railway quarters. The surrounding area has once again been given for farming. Remember, we saw the same thing when we were doing Tunnel 18 walk. And either side of this railway line is the thick mountain forest.
Now, this looks like an abandoned railway line, the one you might see on movies. But unfortunately, this is the main railway line all the way to Badulla, where around dozen trains go every day. Very unfortunate the state of the railway line here. This is the view towards the forest patch. This is part of the Meepilimana mountain range. You can see that fallen tree looks as if it's across a river or something. This is the railway line that we trekked all this time. This is probably one of the most beautiful in Sri Lanka. Now, when was the last time I said it? Probably a couple of minutes ago. Once again, all I have to say is, remember, you need permission to trek along the railway line. So it's imperative you seek permission from the CGR, get you authorization before coming on the railway line. Otherwise, you would be in trouble, so that you can avoid all the unpleasantness which would follow when you are caught. Therefore, I highly recommend seeking permission before getting on these rail hikes. That's a bit of piece of advice.
All right, now the sun is up above, lighting the railway line in patches where the forest cover is not there. You can see how wonderful this stretch is. I know when building this railway line during the colonial era, they must have destroyed lots of mountain forest to build this. But in a way, I'm grateful they did it, because we can enjoy this pristine forest areas thanks to the railway line. If it wasn't there, we would never be able to come into the heart of this and enjoy it like this. Unfortunately, the tourism industry in Sri Lanka, especially when it comes to trekking and hiking, is at a very primitive stage still. We have not been able to utilize the resources we have to the fullest possible ways. That is quite sad. In comparison, countries like India, Nepal, Bhutan are utilizing their resources and protect them to the maximum, because they understand the true value of doing that and promoting responsible tourism. All right, we can hear lots of birds also in this stretch. I mean the flying ones. People always tend to mistake the word bird. So whenever I say birds, those are the flying ones. Nobody else. So keep that in mind. All right, dread having to walk along these concrete sleepers. They are so hard on the knees and joints. And very unstable too, because you can see how narrow they are. You can hardly keep your foot.
Yet another forestry patch. It looks like good for me to walk you on this too.
This stretch has wooden sleepers. They are so unstable because not properly fixed to the ground. So this railway line has not been strengthened so that the trains can go faster. I wish they would do that. However, we saw at some places they have done a very good job of cleaning the railway line and the surrounding area. We are actually expecting the Colombo bound Podi Manike, because we saw Udrad Manike at Nanue station. So we have to wait for the Podi Manike now. Afterwards it would be I think from the railway term, it's the 8 down with the German engine with 6 carriages normally. Afterwards it would be the Candy Mix. It looks as if we would have to catch that one the way we are going, because we are trekking very slowly and we also spend quite a lot of time trying to bring you this footage. Now, I was telling you about how slow trains go on this line. You can see the speed limit to the left, only 15 kilometers an hour. So this is the speed limit most of the upcountry areas. This leads to approximately 12 hour journey from Colombo to Badul. Normally trains travel really fast, almost at 100 kilometers an hour between Colombo Fort and Rambukkana. Afterwards it slows into almost at snail pace.
Yeah, I'm trying to show you one of the few stretches where they have cleared the railway line. However, though they have removed the old sleepers and added new wooden sleepers, there is not much ballast between them. So the railway line is not very strong. Okay, we just came across the Podimanike. Actually, we were not ready for her. It was so unexpected. Thankfully, we were at a very good location where we could move to the side of the railway line and also take a small video clip and couple of pictures too. Now, we are about halfway through our journey. Probably a shade more than half. And to the right now, we can clearly hear the flowing Dambagasthala Oya. Now, what's the other name for the Dambagasthala Oya? Elgin Oya. Yes, Elgin River. She is the one who creates this beautiful Elgin waterfalls. You can get a passing glimpse of when you are on the train, but it's very difficult to get down to the base. Of course, there have been some people who were adventurous enough to do that and got lucky to get to the base and enjoy her. Unfortunately, I have not been able to do that so far. I wonder if I'll ever be able to do that. So folks, wish me luck. Now you can see the Meepilimana mountain range is to our left. This is the railway line laid along the base of it. To our right is a massive ravine where the Dambagasthala Oya flows to merge with Agra Oya. Right, okay. Once again, whenever I start a video, these dreaded concrete sleepers appear from nowhere. I believe you can hear the raging Dambagasthala Oya somewhere down below. Alright, I've decided to walk along this sidewalk because I wanted to give you a better viewing angle of this V-cut. Upcountry railway line boasts so many such V-cuts. Actually, I've lost count of them. Most famous being the Bambarakanda V-cut, which is between Kalupahana and Ohia, which has nothing to do with the railway line though. Now you can see this massive rock, which is part of the Meepilimana mountain range. I suspect we could be in the close vicinity of Conical Hill. Remember the ninth highest mountain in Sri Lanka. So to our left is the Meepilimana Kandyala Houghton Plains Road. Remember the Kandyala Reservoir. And there is Forest Department bungalow, which I got lucky enough to stay once. There's also a Kandyala Educational Center, which is very popular among the school children. Well, it is also popular among other travelers who use that road to visit Houghton Plains. But I'm going to get back on the railway line. Alright, this is somewhat straight railway line
Why I stopped here is, number one, it's beautiful. Needless to say that. To the right, we can see the top of Elgin waterfall. Extreme top. Now you can, if you can make out that white dot somewhere to the right of the frame, that is the top of Elgin Falls. Above that, I can probably make out the mountains in Horton Plains, probably Totopal and Agra Bhopat in the background. Alright, now that we are close to Elgin Waterfall, we are also close to Elgin Bridge. I really wish we were near the Elgin Bridge when this Chinese lady came. That would have been the perfect picture. That would have been the perfect video. Unfortunately, not everything goes your way, people. Remember, things change. Your luck changes. If you watch a recent match, where one of the Sri Lankan bowlers who got a hat-trick in the previous over was hit for six sixes in the very next over. So that's how luck changes. What you need to do is enjoy the good bit and learn from your mistakes. That way you can be good at what you do. Well, once again, it's easier said than done. Now, we are into the 214.5 kilometer post. So I suspect we have trekked so far a little over 5.5 kilometers. So if the railway department distances are correct, we have trekked almost 2/3 of the journey. Almost. However, the measurement I took using Google Earth tells me we are just over halfway mark. I don't know which is correct though. But the railway website says it's 9.3 between Parakumpura and Ambevila. But the Google Earth measurements tells me it's 10.3. It's very difficult to manage or find out the exact distances, elevations without proper equipment. Well, if you have proper equipment, you will further slow down. So I'll just go by the approximate numbers. At the end of the day, there's very little we can do knowing the exact numbers. So as long as you are aware of the close approximate numbers, that should be enough. Now the Ambevila is a very important place, not because of the New Zealand farm or the Highland Milk Factory, but also Ambevila is yet another place where there's a provincial crossing. Remember, we are in Central Province right now. Ambevila station, there is a small sort of like a a triangle shaped provincial border. The point of the triangle at the Ambevila station, which means you are briefly crossing into Uwa province, then back to Central Province. It's sort of like a tip of the pyramid. Then once again you will be in Central Province. So the stretch between Ambevila and Pattipola, if my memory serves me right, it's approximately 3 to 4 kilometers in length. The elevation difference is 52 meters, and you cross the provincial border into Uwa at the Highland Milk Factory. Remember, the railway line goes behind the Highland Milk Factory. So that's where the Central Province crosses to Uwa and it stays there until the Pattipola Forest Department bungalow just passing Pattipola station. Well, I'm panting, people. I can't remember when I last had water. Anyway, I'll stop you here. Okay, it looks like there is a linesman hut here. Yeah, they probably take a break and have a brew.
Just look at this, people. This is the linesman hut I just showed you a while ago. There are two camp beds built using railway sleepers. Oh, I wish I could really spend a night here. I know it will be frozen cold, but I wouldn't mind spending a night here if given a chance. Here is the Elgin Falls. Unfortunately, water levels are not so good. When I came here last month, while traveling on the train, I saw plenty more water. This is a zoomed view of Elgin Falls. Let's get closer. This is a zoomed in view of the Elgin Falls. This is the Elgin Falls, hidden in the thick mountain forest. You can see the bottom part of the Elgin Falls.
Okay, now we are very close to Elgin Bridge. You saw the waterfall. Unfortunately, the water levels were not very good compared to my last visit exactly 1 month ago. It seems the drought has finally hit really hard to the central province. However, I saw there's a change of weather from tomorrow onwards. There are some showers expected. Well, it is a good thing. Unlike in the past days, current status is not very good for the retention of water levels in the upcountry due to the clearing of mountain forests, soil erosion, and many other reasons. Water no longer retains in the highlands, seep towards the lowlands gradually. Instead, during the rains, they just flow like a river or waterfall. Then as soon as rains are over, it goes back to its normal dry self. This is the reason why you can't see waterfalls very beautifully unless it's heavily raining. This is another sign that we are heading into becoming a desert. The longer we do this unethical clearing of forests, the sooner we can become another desert in South Asia. Here we are at last at Elgin Bridge. It looks so beautiful. I've always wanted to come and visit her. Especially, I didn't know the prominence of this when I trekked here in 2013. So, very recently, I badly wanted to come and see her. Finally, my dream has come through. There's also abandoned railway quarters here. Just imagine you being able to spend a couple of days here enjoying this beautiful Elgin Bridge. That would be just insane. You can enjoy the scenery, quietness of the mountains, forest, and beautiful trains on the bridge.
This is the railway quarters located very close to Elgin Bridge, giving a grand view of the bridge. Oh, how I wish I could spend some days here. Just doing nothing but looking at this beautiful creation and enjoying the tranquility of the upcountry. Hardly visible signage. from the Ambevil side. You can see one of the linesmen's crossing it. Very friendly person. We had a nice little chat. It's always important to talk to these people because they hardly ever come across people. So it's sort of like a very good experience for them as well as for you, because you gain a lot of knowledge about the surrounding, sometimes very interesting stories about the railway, and they also get to speak to some fellow human beings. Very, very interesting. I really can't get enough of this Elgin Bridge. I really wish I can stay at those quarters. Whoever built them must have had great imagination. Just imagine, people, you being able to stay there, enjoy a couple of trains, have a nice cozy meal and a nap, listen to the music of the nature. But right now there's a bit of clearing going, so you can hear some equipment noise. Finally, a dream has come through. I am on top of the Elgin Bridge. Badulla bound Podimanik is due in about half an hour time, but we can't afford to spend that long here. We need to go to Ambevil and catch the goods train, because we are definitely going to miss 8 down. So it will be the 3 o'clock goods train. We have to return back to our place. Anyway, it's so nice to be able to stay here. Once again, I'm keeping an eye on those quarters. I really hope I'll be able to come and spend a night over there one day before I say goodbye to this world. For that, people, give me your wishes to be able to achieve that target. Right, let's continue the journey towards Ambevil then.
Here I am walking past Elgin Bridge. It was a dream come true, people. Such a wonderful experience. I think the Elgin Bridge is approximately 100 to 125 meters in length, if I'm not mistaken. And it's so high, there's a stream that goes to join Damagasthala Oya, which ultimately joins Mahaveli River. Now we are approximately 2 miles from Ambevil railway station. That translates into 3.2 kilometers. The way we are going, I'm sure it will take us another 2 hours to reach Ambevil. So it's a sure sign we are going to miss the German lady going to Colombo, but we'll get lucky to get on board the second German lady who is going to Kandy, the mix one. The downside is she is running so slow, allowing all the other trains to go past her. So we are going to have to spend more time getting back to our overnight destination. Alright, I think I'll have to stop you somewhere here, because I need to try and step up the journey, and I can't seem to find Atha. Has he gone in search of Elgin Falls? Oh my goodness, he is so far ahead. At least couple hundred meters. Okay, I'll have to hurry. This is the distant view of Elgin Bridge, and there is a mountain behind her. I wonder if that is the conical hill. What a great find. I can't be 100% sure. This is just a guess. She could even be the Kandyala peak. The bridge, quarters and the mountain can be seen beautifully from here. This is a beautiful picture also. Now my legs are getting so tired. Remember, this is a very long rail hike. Well, relatively long rail hike. And of course, we are not getting any younger. Our bones and muscles are getting older, so they get tired quite easily now. Anyway, Remember, I have a dream now. I want to come and stay at those railway quarters. And I would try my best to make that happen. And I need your wishes. If you are watching this, please give me your wishes for me to come and spend a day or two there. Now we are almost about 2 kilometers before Ambevila railway station. Now we can see the signs of the Ambevila villages. We can now see some farmlands, and some of them have been abandoned. Badullabawun Poddi should be coming behind me anytime soon, and we need to watch our step, because she can jump you from nowhere. Remember, in the morning Kalambubawun Poddi came out of nowhere, so we had very little time to react, but we were expecting her, so there were no problems. Now we should come across the sluice gates of Ambevila Reservoir over the Black Pool very soon to our right, as well as the parts of New Zealand farm of Ambevila, which is another grand location. I intend to do a walk from the Ambevila railway station to the New Zealand farm one of these days. Though it's a road hike, that would give us some beautiful panoramic landscapes of the New Zealand farm and surrounding Horton Plains National Park. We can also get a closer view of the Ambevila Reservoir. And afterwards, just before the railway platform, we would be crossing to Uwa very briefly, maybe a couple of feet, and then back to Central Province. I might have tripped there. Anyway, now I can feel there's this chilly wind. I could also feel some drops of water on my skin. I wonder, remember I told you a change of weather is expected tomorrow. I wonder if it is already happening. Oh my goodness, this is just unbelievable. So beautiful. Now we can see the 216.5 mark. So we have trekked according to the railway these posts roughly 7 to 7.5 kilometers, because I can't remember if we started at 209 or 209.5 close to Parakumpura. Nevertheless, it's 7.5 maximum, which means if we have 10 kilometers as per the Google Earth, 2.5 to go. If it is 9.3 as per the railway, roughly another 1.5. I wish railway department stats are accurate, because I can really take a nice little break. But quite saddening that we would have a long wait at Ambevila station waiting for the mixed train to Kandy. You know, the wicked thought is for the 8 down to get late by 1 hour so that we can catch it. But just because it's convenient for me, I should not wish for that, because there is a train load of people who would want to go to their destination soon as possible. So I shouldn't be selfish and wish for the train delay, though they are quite prevalent in Sri Lankan railways. Anyway, perish the thought. Three, perish the thought. You can't be wicked. Now, you can see that's quite open stretches. You might also be able to make out a telecommunication tower in the distance. I wonder if you are really that close to the Ambevila station, because the last thing I need is to miss the train by about 500 meters. That would be heartbreaking. So waiting at Ambevila station for 1.5 hours doesn't seem very appealing under the circumstances. Oh, I heard a bit of a hoot. Don't tell me Chinese lady is already behind me. Right, I think it's time for me to take a break and quicken my steps so that we might, you never know, we might get to the station before the German lady. As you can see, I'm back on this sidewalk, which is enough for a motorbike. If you remember, we saw a motorbike going through the summit level the other day. That was quite an experience. I was waiting for a Chinese lady. I heard her hooting very close to the summit level. Out of nowhere appeared that motorbike. So I wonder if they are maintaining this sort of like the footpath so that farmers can reach their farmlands using motorbikes. They could also bring their vegetable harvest in sacks on the back of the motorbike to the stations or to the main road. Okay, once again, we are inside this thick forest. So we just passed a very tiny patch of open area with a farmland. Once again, in the thick forest. But you know, people, I can now see the 217th kilometer post. This indicates I trekked, rather both Atha and me trekked 500 meters in about under 10 minutes. So if that were to be a measurement, that is 500 into 6, that's 3 kilometers an hour. Very decent speed. Remember, we can't sustain that speed. So we are probably doing about 2 kilometers an hour. We started from Parakumpura roughly 10 o'clock. Remember, we had a nice little chat with the farmer. Enjoyed the beauty of Parakumpura and Sripada. So the time is now 1 o'clock, just past 1 o'clock. So 3 hours. So we have walked approximately 7 to 7.5 kilometers. Not bad. Average 2.5 kilometers an hour. If only we were able to reach Parakumpura 1 hour earlier, this wouldn't have been a problem. That's part of the package. Okay, now this path is very nice. It's getting wide. I wonder if it's gonna get wide enough for a tuk-tuk. Okay, never ending bends. In this stretch, railway line seems to be in relatively decent shape. I can see there is some ballast. Sleepers have been changed. There are new strong wooden sleepers. So the railway line looks better in comparison. So the trains might be able to run slightly faster, but remember, the line doesn't maintain this through and through, making trains won't be able to sustain the speeds constantly. So until they get the entire railway line, or at least a decent chunk of it, in good strong order, we would not be able to reduce the traveling time. Oh, mind you, they would also have to stop train stopping at every tiny little station. Okay, I'm going to go from here. All right, we are now I think closing in on Ambevela. Guess what? There is still no sign of the Chinese lady. I know I sound very elated and hopeful. And now in this stretch, we actually came across a couple of purple-faced leaf monkeys, also known as black monkeys. They are endemic to Sri Lanka. So it's a very important species. We need to look after them. Though we have them in large numbers in comparison to leopards and probably tuskers and elephants, still you would need to protect them. Remember, the Rilava is also endemic to Sri Lanka. Unfortunately, we have way many of them, and they cause a lot of destruction because Polonnaruwa, especially those ancient city of Polonnaruwa, is full of them. Now I have for some reason forgotten their English name. Okay, I can see sort of like a greenhouse up front. And we are actually, Atula and me, both struggling to keep pace because the hike uphill along the railway line have tested our muscles and bones to the limit. So we are literally crawling along this railway line. But remember, there are no regrets whatsoever. I told you it's part of the package. The older you get, you need to be mindful of the length of your hikes. I think it's time for us to cut down the length of the hike we undertake on a day. Otherwise, we will break down fairly soon. Instead, if you were careful enough, cut down the intensity of the hike, we can keep going for a little longer. You know, the life is so uncertain, you never know. Still no sign of the Chinese lady. You know, the wicked self in me doesn't stop smiling, and he doesn't stop wishing for train delays.
I wonder if these two have eloped from the Ambevela New Zealand farm. If I'm not mistaken, this is the Ambevela bungalow. This can be seen on Google Maps. Beautiful structure. Probably the architecture goes towards colonial era. I wish. Okay, I won't say it because you know what I'm going to say now. This is the railway line towards Pathakumpura. I'm standing with the Ambevela behind me. That is the road towards New Zealand farm. Down below you can see some beautifully done vegetable patches. I think we are very close to the Ambevela sluice gate. Did you see the Chinese lady carrying a rail cart? That was quite a surprise. I managed to capture a few seconds of it. Hope it has come right.
Okay, right, you saw the road towards Ambevela New Zealand farm. Just before that you saw the Chinese lady pulling a rail cart. That was, I don't know, I was so surprised. I was just about to finish the video to see, oh my goodness, there was a rail cart attached to the train and going at speed. Then I managed to turn around and take, I think, few seconds of it, tried to zoom in also. Don't know if the footage, as of now, I don't know if the footage is any good. I hope, fingers crossed, people, because if it is, you would also be lucky enough to see that. Because a train carrying, rather pulling a rail cart is always a wonderful sight. Okay, now that, come to think of it, rail cart, that is yet another dream of mine. To be able to go on a rail cart being pulled by a German lady. I actually want it to be pulled by a German lady, but now that the upcountry is predominantly run by Chinese ladies, chances are not quite bright. Anyway, I don't know if I'll ever be able to go on rail cart in the first place, but there's no harm in my hoping. These hopes are the ones which keep us going, aren't they? Okay, I think we should be able to go and see the Ambevila sluice gate very soon. I told you previously, that's one of the starting point of the Dambagasthala Oya, one of the headwaters of mighty Mahaveli River. Okay, we should also expect now the German lady to appear. She should come now from Ambevila. Alright. That is probably the signal she is departing Ambevila. Do you know, we missed her in about half an hour. Oh, what a pity. What a pity, what a pity. Okay, it sounds like Watupiti and Watapita, right? Anyway. Okay, I'm going to stop here and capture the German lady.
This is sort of like an aerial view of the railway line. I managed to climb to this side hill while waiting for the German lady. Okay, here comes the German lady with lots of noises.
Okay, we just saw the Colombo-bound German lady running at speed. Fortunately, we got lucky enough to find that elevated position where we could get a nice aerial view of her. And she looked very beautiful. Green and maroon German lady. Unfortunately, we were not able to catch her. So my wicked self is now very sad. Good for him. Now that we have roughly 1 hour remaining for the next train, which is the Candy Mix. So we will have enough time to go to Ambevila station, take a break and end our journey properly. But that means it would take us extra 2 hours to complete today's hike. It's alright, baby, it's alright. It's all part of the package.
This is a view of the Ambevila sluice gates. As you can see, a tuk-tuk going. Ambevila Reservoir or Blackpool. Starting point of Dambagasthala Oya. You can now see a clear view of the Ambevila Reservoir Bund, and the road goes over it. Okay, we can probably get a view of a vehicle passing. Sluice gate is to the right. Okay, there is a car, there is a lorry, many vehicles. Right, let's continue our journey then. This is the road. I said I plan to come and do a road walk because that's very scenic and picturesque.
We can make out the signal tower slightly ahead. There's also a very healthy water stream to our right, which also join Tambagasthala Avaya in addition to the excess water coming out of the Ambevila Reservoir. This is sort of like a marshy land. I'll go close and show you. But now, okay, I can see Ambevila station in the distance. Less than half a kilometer. So we have another 1 hour for the next train. It might give us time to relax our feet, take a break, and enjoy the Ambevila station, because that's also a very nice station, the second highest after all in Sri Lankan railway stations. So there's no harm in us spending some quality time close to the Ambevila station. To our right is the road from Ambevila to New Zealand Farm. To the left is the same road which is coming from Nuwareli and Nanuwe side, passing Pilimatalava and Blackpool and Kandiyala Reservoir too. And up ahead, the road branches off, one to the right towards New Zealand Farm, the other one goes all the way towards Pattipola and then Houghton Plains. In addition to this, there is another road that connects Ambevila with Rendapola. Samya along Nuwareli Valimada Road, close to Kappettipola. That's another road. So it's like a four-way junction, Ambevila. Okay, the weather has certainly made a turn, because I can feel some big droplets of water on me. Thankfully, unlike other days, I have my GoPro. So this is probably a good time to test it. How good a waterproof camera it is, after all. My goodness, these twists and turns are never ending. And also there are quite a lot of farmlands which were not there when I came here in 2013. So, alright, I'll hold my comments. And they are going to be very controversial, because I'm more towards the nature. I'm against this excessive forest clearings. I'm against excessive usage and contamination of water in the upcountry. But you know, there's always two sides of the coin. I'm actually looking at one side, but I'm quite sad to see these developments after all, because over usage is not a very good thing in whatever we do.
This is the view towards the way that we came from Parakumpura. You can see the farmlands on either side of the railway line. And there are two kids coming my way. The marshy land and the tiny water stream is to my left now.
Now we are really, really close to Ambevila station. Okay, I'm gonna follow these two kids. Now I can almost see the station and the railway crossing. We just passed the second signal tower, and there are machines working in the vegetable fields nearby. It seems there were some tourists today, being a Friday, visiting Ambevela, Pattipola and Houghton Plains. Now the rain is actually coming a little thick and fast. We have to wait another 1 hour or so for the train to go back. Unfortunately, we missed the green and maroon German lady going to Colombo. I think in about half an hour. It was a great pity. If only we had another half an hour, we would have made it.
This is the beautiful Ambevela railway station. End of our rail hike from Pathakumpura to Ambevela. Almost 10 kilometers.
Alright, let's go close to the station and then we can end the journey from Ambevela. The rail hike we took from Pathakumpura to Ambevela, close to 10 kilometers. Elevation gain is roughly 132 meters and it took us approximately 4 hours to complete this.
Okay people, this is time to end our journey then from Ambevela railway station. I'll see you with another rail hike sometime in the future. All of you stay safe and take care.